I'm Rob Fitridge. I'm Professor of Vascular Surgery at the University of Adelaide and a vascular and endovascular surgeon at the Royal Adelaide and Queen Elizabeth Hospitals. The focus of my research at the moment is wound healing in patients with diabetes-related foot complications. And diabetes-related foot complications are responsible for about 70 or 80% of all amputations in Australia. There are several major problems with diabetes from a patient perspective. It's not only managing their sugars, but in the long term, you know, kidney problems, so renal failure is a problem, eye problems, so people get retinopathy and potentially blindness, and people get peripheral neuropathy, which means their sensory nerves as well as motor nerves, but mainly the problem is sensory nerves in their lower limb, particularly foot, are damaged so that they can't feel very well. So you can injure your foot, get a blister, knock your foot, get an ulcer without realising that it's there. The other problem with diabetes to some extent is it's a risk factor for arterial disease, blocked arteries. So that a lot of our patients, probably half the patients that develop an ulcer, will have problems with blood flow to the foot. So one of the basic issues that's problematic in wound healing in diabetes is a lack of what we call angiogenesis, or a new blood vessel formation, or sprouting, if you like, of the small blood vessels to allow oxygen and nutrients into a wound so that you can get, you know, wound healing to occur. So the basic studies have showed that you can get what we call stem cells, which are from the bone marrow, that migrate into the ulcer and areas of ischemia, and they allow new blood vessels to form, which will allow healing to occur. So the problem is, though, how do you get, you know, stem cells, which are deficient in diabetes, into the wound? And Prof. Cowan's group have basically found a way to get stem cells which can reproduce that will stick to a patch. So, and then that patch we can actually put onto the wound and replace it. And that will, you know, get stem cells directly in touch with the wound, and that should improve or reverse the deficiency of angiogenesis, or new blood vessel formation, adequate perfusion to the ulcer, and wound healing. So that's what we're working on now, and over the next year or so we hope to, you know, study a group of patients and work out whether that's actually going to be of benefit to our patients. People without diabetes can get ulcers as well. So the aim of the exercise, I guess, is to improve healing in patients with diabetes so that they heal in the same way as someone without diabetes. So you're not necessarily making the wound healing better than it would be in someone without diabetes, but you're certainly trying to get the healing in a diabetic patient the same as someone who hasn't got diabetes. And people with diabetes do have delayed healing compared to people without diabetes. Having a wound is a major problem for a person. Not only is it often painful, but you know, you're really restricted in terms of what you can do. You have to be available either every day or two or three times a week for dressings. As soon as you've got an ulcer or a wound, the risk of infection's quite high. So, you know, as well as doing the dressings, you know, there's a significant risk of developing an infection, which may need a hospital stay, antibiotics. And if you've got quite a nasty wound, there is a risk of amputation. And that can be just a toe or part of the front of the foot, or it can be below the knee. And, you know, major amputation is one of the worst things that can happen to people. People, you know, fear it very much, and it certainly can affect your quality of life. May stop you working. You know, if you're need to walk or drive or whatever, that can be catastrophic from that perspective. You know, not everyone who has an amputation can get a prosthesis on and walk afterwards. So, you know, really preventing ulceration in the foot, getting it healed as soon as possible, are absolutely critical. And it's a very expensive condition to manage, both for the system but also for the patient themselves.